Welcome to Anson Griffin's occasional series on Matlab tutorials. Today we're going to be looking at normxcorr2, which is template matching. And if you're not familiar with that, I've done another one on YouTube which explains normxcorr2. Imtransfrom, that'll be used to work out the transformation of two objects between two different images. And finally, we'll be using the visreg function, which is from Gonzalez, Woods and Hinton's book, which will overlap two images. So we're ready to roll, and I'm going to run the script from here. I'll give you a chance to see the script at the end. So the frame, using MMReader, we can see it's 25 frames per second, and there's a total of 42 frames. And you can just see the car going by there. So we just saw the car going by. We can shut that down. And there are two images here. We're just going to give you a chance to see what's going on. So you can just see in the title here, frame 11 and frame 18. So I was in the upstairs bedroom, and you can see here frame 11 here on the left hand side, and then in frame 18. So I wanted to work out between frame 11 and frame 18, what was the velocity of that car. So using normxcorr2, the change in the horizontal was 132. Now if this was truly parallel transformation, the change in the vertical would be zero, but it's close enough to be zero, so that'll do. So 132 pixels in the x direction. Now we wanted some sort of scale, so I measured the length of the white line that's just there that I'm pointing to at the moment, just there, and I got out my tape measure and I took a photograph, and it was 2.88 meters long. How many pixels is that white line? Well, let me just bring this down here a bit. Use the ruler tool. And it's a little hit and miss, but it's around there. And I right button click, and I'm going to export this variable called distance. Shut that down. And so just carry on then, and by doing a bit of maths we can work out the velocity of the car is 8 meters per second, which is around 28 to 29 kilometers per hour. And you'll see the script at the end. We can work out the velocity by using the fact that there's 7/25 of a second between the two frames. Now the next thing we're going to do is use imtransfrom to work out the parallel transformation between the two. So here we are, and there's a minimum of two control points in each, but we're going to take more than that. We just select corresponding points. Now a minimum of two, but as you would suspect, the more you take, the more reliable your answer. So just be reasonably careful here. And there, more or less in a straight line, so we just take one or two from down here. And I think that should do us. Now, do I want to save the control points? I do. And I want to save it into a structure called cpconstruct. That will contain the forward transformation and the inverse transformation. So just go back here one sec. There's the structure of tcar. It contains T and T inverse. So T is the forward transformation, so that is the parallel transformation going from A to B, and the parallel transformation going from B to A is there. Now again, you'd want to be okay with your homography and to understand what's going on here, but I just assume you are. Let's just go back here just one sec, and using the MATLAB Edens and Woods function visreg, we've overlapped the two images, we've given the projective transfer, or sorry, not the projective, the parallel transformation, and we can see the two pictures overlaid. We can see that the parallel transformation is fairly accurate. Why? Because there's no shadow or jutter or whatever the word is, say, on this this pier here or that pier here. So our assumption that it was a parallel transformation is fairly good. That's about it. Just go back here now to the script, and I'll just slowly scroll down here. Line 6, so we've just using the MATLAB MM reader. So we read in the frames. Just scroll down slowly. On line 28 there, I played it. On line 34 and on line 36, I got frame 11 and I got frame 18. On line 45, I read in the car template. Now, what I did was I actually took frame 11 and I used IM crop just to get the picture of the car on its own. On line 48 and line 49, I've used normxcorr2, that's the template matching, in frame 11 and frame 18 to get the position of the car. And then on lines 53, 54, 55, 56, I worked out the change in the X and the change in the Y between frame 11 and frame 18. On line 62, I used the IM tool command, and why did I use that? Because I wanted to get the distance in pixels of the white line, and that'll be recorded there in distance, that variable on line 62. Using the ruler command, I returned distance, and then I worked out the scale there, and then on line 68 I worked out the distance traveled, and then on line 73 the time elapsed was 7/25 of a second, and on line 75 I worked out the velocity. Going on a little bit more, cpselect brought up that command where you saw the frame 11 and frame 18, and I used my mouse to select the number of corresponding points. 2 is the minimum for a parallel transformation, but I use 6 or 7 because the more you take, the more reliable you get. And if you've done stats or anything like that, or in geosurveying or geomatics, you do at least squares adjustment. So MATLAB does all of that for you. I worked out there, I worked it out what the transform was, and I told it was linear conformal, so that would be a parallel transformation. On line 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, I worked out the forward and inverse transformation, or not that I worked it out, I just got MATLAB to display it. Just going down a little bit then, and then on line 105 I used a MATLAB function from Gonzalez Woods and Edens' book to overlay the two photos. So I overlaid, I gave it 3 inputs, that's the first, that's frame 11, the last is frame 18, and the transformation, which I worked out myself. Okay, thanks very much, bye.